Well, this here is not a worm, it is a face mite, and today I would like to show you how you can catch those face mites, because they're growing right here in your eyebrows, and how you can put them under the microscope, just like I have done here. Hi, hello and welcome, Microbehunter here. I've made already several face mite videos in the previous months, and yes, I keep on coming back to those face mites, because they are indeed one of my favorite little animals. I do understand that maybe not everyone might like them, but they are quite fascinating, and they're quite easy to catch if you know what you're doing. And with a microscope, they can be also quite interesting to observe, because they do move around and they do crawl around on the microscope slide as well. First, I would like to talk a little bit about face mites in general, in case you do not know them yet. And then later in the second part of this video, I'm going to show you how you can catch them fairly easily. Well, first of all, the good news, pretty much everyone's got face mites. And I say it's good news because this means that you've plenty of face mites available for microscopic observations, because after all, that's why you're here. You would like to observe nature under the microscope, and I have good news for you. Of course, they're quite easy to catch, and if you do not know what to observe under the microscope, just pull a few of those face mites out of your eyelashes. I'm going to show you. Those face mites were discovered in the 1840s, 1841, 1842, and essentially at the beginning, they already knew, well, these are probably mites because they have got 8 legs. So even though they might look a little bit like worms because of the long, slender body, if you actually zoom in quite a bit, you can actually see that they have 8 legs. The face mites live in the so-called in the hair follicles of your eyelashes, also of your eyebrows. And the hair follicles are those parts of the skin where the hair actually starts to grow. They feed on the oil and the fat that your skin produces. And this basically means that young children, especially newborns, they do not have any face mites yet. The older you become, especially if your skin starts to become greasier with age, then pretty much everyone will have those face mites. Generally, they do not cause any problems. But if there are too many of them growing on your skin, then essentially they might cause a condition called rosacea, which looks a little bit like very strong acne. But otherwise, they're pretty harmless. They're just part of the normal part of our body. The human body is an ecosystem after all. So if you would like to observe them under the microscope, what do you have to do? Well, quite easy. You have to first squeeze them out of the hair follicles. And you do that by carefully grabbing your eyelashes and pulling on them. Don't rip them out, but carefully pull on them and rotate the eyelashes. You can either do that with your fingers or with tweezers. I've got those very flat tweezers, which allow you to actually hold those eyelashes better. And if you do that for a couple of seconds, then the face mites will be squeezed out of their hair follicles. You then take a little bit of sticky tape, regular scotch tape, sticky tape, and you press against your eyelashes. You do that, make sure that you have good contact here. And then any face mites that have been squeezed out will now be on the sticky tape that you've pressed against your eyes. You glue the tape with the sticky surface on top on a microscope slide, and you simply put it under the microscope and you look for them. Usually, I've always found 1 to 2 face mites after this procedure. So it's a fairly efficient way. It might be a little bit difficult to find them if there are many skin cells present, usually with 4 times or even 10 times magnification, you have absolutely no problems in finding those. Now, of course, you can just observe them on the sticky tape as it is, but if you would like to see them move around a little bit better, or if you would like to have a better image quality, then I recommend that you take a microliter pipette and that you add a little bit, a small drop of oil. Just regular cooking oil is fine. And this cooking oil will dissolve the glue on the tape a little bit, and it will also flush up and suck in the face mite. So you simply add a little drop of oil and then you suck it back in and you transfer the face mite on a microscope slide. And then you can basically do with it whatever you want. Yeah. The oil is absolutely not a problem for the face mite because it likes to feed on oil anyway. And what you see here is a face mite moving around on my microscope slide, and you see that there is still a little bit of oil around the face mite, so it's kind of pulling along the oil as well. And it's got quite a heavy load to carry here. That's pretty much it. And what I would recommend is the following. I'd like to invite you. I did put a link into my Reddit page, and if you would like to share your face mite pictures as well with the community, please visit the page, and then you can also share a couple of those pictures that you've made. Happy microbe hunting. See you around next time. Bye-bye.